Today I want to talk about how Florida State managed to get beat down by a city state, some other takeaways from an afternoon of college football, and all that's coming up after the bumper.
What do you mean you don't subscribe to my son's YouTube channel?
Mama, no!
Just snap the damn ball, RJ.
What's up, kid folk? It's RJ Young. I am not on a step mill. Consider hitting the like and subscribe button because I upload a video every single day. It's always OU related, college football related, sports related. We have a good time. And today, I want to take a look at week one through about the mid-afternoon, just basically finishing the 11 a.m. kickoffs where, hey, I took my first L in picking winners, and we're going to talk about it. But first, hashtag SEC is trash if you're watching Memphis versus Ole Miss. Now, first, Memphis was favored to win that game. Memphis is favored in every single game they're going to play this year because Mike Norvell all of a sudden has that team humming after what you saw last year where he put Daryl Henderson and Tony Pollard into the draft, came back with Patrick Taylor Jr., and all they did was get a W against an SEC foe at home, 15-10. Now, if you had Ole Miss to cover, yeesh, because what you saw was Memphis is up 13-10, and then Ole Miss gives up a safety late into the fourth. They end up winning that game 15-10, which is a point more than the spread. Yeesh. However, anytime we get an opportunity to dunk on the SEC, I'm going to take it because the SEC is the best conference in college football, but they keep telling you that. So we got guys with Croakleys and wallet chains coming up to us going, Big 12's trash, Big 10's trash, Pac-12's trash, which is actually true, ACC's trash. All right, now we get to talk about the SEC being trash because, well, Memphis did that. On the flip side, Iowa State, we want to love you. We want to love you. Matt Campbell, I want to love you. And yet you got to take this into Nut Cup territory with needing triple overtime to beat Northern Iowa. And if you're not watching the game, and you're just looking at the stat sheet, you're going, Brock Purdy didn't actually play poorly. Like, I'm looking at it, and the dude went 30 of 41 for 278 yards, two sacks, no picks, two TDs. It's decent. I think Breece Hall has an opportunity to be the best freshman in the Big 12 this year, running back there. And they didn't really turn the ball over. They had one turnover. Northern Iowa didn't have any. And then the third down efficiency was good for Iowa State, 7 of 18, whereas Northern Iowa was 6 of 17. They had 26 first downs. Like, you're looking at this going, y'all just going to take it there. I guess. Okay. And when push comes to shove, I will send a fully armed battalion to remind you of my love. Da 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 da. Austin Kendall finished his season opener against James Madison, 27 of 42 for 260 yards with a TD. Yo, that's not bad. That's 64%. No, amen. That's a great opener. I like it. Austin Kendall with a nice line coming out. All right, jump cut because I had to cough and it was really scratching my throat through that first part. You know, I don't like jump cuts. I'm talking about Boise State and Florida State. All right, so Florida State is given 6.5 when this game was supposed to be played on a neutral site, and then the game got moved to Doak Campbell in Tallahassee because there's a little thing called Hurricane Dorian coming through, and if you are in the line of sight, in the path of destruction, I hope you got to safety. I hope you're okay. I hope that if you have to rebuild, that it goes well for you. Now, all of that, Boise State has to travel further than they thought they were going to have to travel. They have to play an actual road game, and they're starting a true freshman quarterback. So if you're willing to give Florida State the win plus the points, like me, you're going, yeah, absolutely. Kendal Briles is going to get that offense humming. Cam Akers was a Heisman candidate a year ago. You thought he was going to be decent this year. James Blackman is a decent enough quarterback. And Kendal Briles is going to be able to put in an offense that's going to make them go. Got a new offensive line coach. Willie Taggart did all the things that you wanted to do except hold on to Sam Howell as a, you know, commit who's playing at North Carolina, and we'll talk about that later. But goodness me, they came out like gangbusters, right? So they go up 31-13, and you're thinking this game is over. And if you didn't check back for like an hour, you're like, wait a second. How is it 33-31 Boise State? Well, I'll tell you how. Hank Bachmeier is a problem. And anybody who's got brothers and sisters who are named Bear, Tiger, and Buck, yeah, you probably come from good stock. All Hank Bachmeier did was go 30 of 51, 407 yards with a pick and a TD. and he was able to stand in the pocket and deliver some strikes. Like, there was a 3rd and 17 late into the fourth that they need to convert to basically ensure a victory, and my man stood in the pocket and dropped a dime. And then he had help from dudes like Robert Mahone, 24 carries for 142 yards, but he did most of his work, I think, blocking. Like, he just picked up protection like it was nothing. I was impressed by what he did. I continue to go down this list, man. I'm going, Kendal Briles doesn't have an intermediate call in the playbook when he's working from behind. That's got to change, because between that offense and Gus Miles on offense, you're going, do you guys run more than like three routes? No, apparently you don't. So all James Blackman is doing is trying to stand back there while routes develop, and all Boise State's defense is doing is coming to eat him alive. As a matter of fact, on third downs, this is where the game was won and lost for me. Florida State was 1 of 12, where Boise State was 10 of 19. Better than 50% on third down for Boise State, 1 of 12 for Florida State. Hashtag not good. Now, we're getting into the... Man. So Boise State puts up 621 yards of offense against Florida State, 200 of which came on the ground. 621 yards. 621. Now, I get it. Boise State ran a bunch of plays. Florida State didn't. But you're Florida State. When has it ever been okay for you to give up this amount of yardage? It's not like you got Oklahoma's defense. It's not like you got Houston's defense. My goodness. How do you give up 621 yards of offense to a city state? Now, I know there's a lot of OU fans that are like, man, how are you on Boise State? I am on Boise State. Boise State is a problem. Hank Bachmeier is going to be a problem for the next 2 years, in which case, keep playing like this, you're going to be talking about him like you're talking about Trevor Lawrence. Dude is a player. And then some tip-ins here, man. Check this out. Not only has Boise State come back from an 18-point deficit to win on the road, they held Florida State scoreless in the second half. Goose eggs for Florida State in the second half. Like, in the fourth quarter, Boise State had like 142 yards of offense. Florida State had two. My goodness. And last, Nebraska. What the hell are you doing? Because I didn't, but somebody put a 4-10 Nebraska inside the top 25. And there were enough of them that they were ranked 24th in the country in the preseason poll. At this rate, Nebraska ain't even going to be ranked by the time that they have to play Ohio State in September, which is like right now. Scott Frost in year two, everybody was betting on it, but you can't, because look at what Adrian Martinez was able to do against South Alabama. Just 13 of 22 for 178 yards. And a pick. My goodness. What are we talking about? Maurice Washington got to play. Scott Frost is going to have to talk about that, because that dude's being arraigned on a misdemeanor and felony charge. So those are the takeaways from now. We'll talk about some other stuff later. Deuces.